So what's good, everybody? Today I'll be showing you how to create a custom overlay in OBS using Canva for free. I do have the paid version. The paid version is better because you can take out the background, remove background and so on and so on. And you have different premium features that you can also use. But I'm going to just do it as if it's a free version. So let's get into it. Okay, here we go. We inside Canva. What I usually do, you could just go ahead and put custom, and I always use the 1920 by 1080. Now you could design this however you want. I'm going to create a, let's see how I'm gonna do this background. Let's just do an all black background. And then let's go to design. You can actually type in animated. Let's say background. See, these are pro. So everything that you see that has a little crown on it is pro, which means you would have to pay the monthly subscription for it. Let's go full screen here. So like this one here is free, so you can just put that there if you want. Okay, so now the next step is to gonna grab this here, a shape. And let's click out the shape, and it's probably going to be the size of the window. I'll make that a little smaller, say about here. Now you could pick whatever color you want. Let's just keep that color, and then I'm going to duplicate it. Actually, let's round the edges first. So let's go here. I'll probably go about 51%, 50. And then I'm going to duplicate it. Then let's move that down. I'm going to make this actually black. Okay, got that as black. And then should I put the black? Yeah, let's put the black in the front. So what I do is I hit control and bracket. You can do this right here. Go to layers and then bring to front right here. Okay, let's see. I'm actually going to expand this a little bit more. Let's make this a little bigger. Well, a little smaller here. Well, you could design this however you want. I'm just making a border. Which you could do a border without having to do it like this. You could just pick the border up here. Now, let's say this is going to be where my screen share is. So if I'm sharing the screen with someone, let me duplicate this one more time. Duplicate. I'm going to change this to green because I'm going to key it out in OBS. So let's change that color. Let's do like that color, and let's shrink it a tiny bit. Okay, so now I'm just group this together, group. And let's place it to where it's like centered here. Now I'm going to duplicate this again. I'm gonna move this over here. And let's say this would be my window. Actually, let's swap this. I want this over here. Then I'll be over here. Okay, so let's say if that's this is going to be where my camera is, and then this is going to be where my screen share is. So you could go and click and add another page. I'll duplicate it if you want to set it up for, like, if you got a guest, then you could just delete that one. Oops. You could just delete that and then duplicate this. And then you hit Control D to duplicate it again if you want three. And let's center this a little better here. Put that to the edge. That way, so we can have three guests here. I'm not going to do that right now. I'm just going to do this one. And I'm going to export it as a MP4. There we go. So now what we're going to do, I'm just going to create a folder in my picture section. New folder. I'll just say OBS overlay from Canva. Then you can name it whatever you want. I'll just put host and share. Share screen. Save. Okay. So now we got that done. Let's shrink that down. Okay, here we go. In OBS, what we're going to do is we're going to create, let's bring our camera in first. So we're going to do video capture device. You can name it whatever you want. I'm going to pick my, that camera. Oh, let's enable preview. There we go. And then I'm going to add a media source. You can name that whatever you want also. Make sure you turn on loop if you're using an MP4 one with video. That's that way it'll loop. It won't disappear on you. So you're going to go to wherever you save your image at or your MP4. If you're using a static, then you don't have to click on that loop. Just hit OK. So now we got this green screen here. You can either right click or you can go to filter. Click on add filter, then we're going to do color key. Okay. Now I'm going to click here, custom color, select, pick, and I'm going to pick that color. Okay. Now you notice we got little green little edges on here, so let's pull this out. There it goes. You go too far, it starts to look like looking really bad. You just want to take the green out there. Soften the edges a little bit. Not too much. Okay, then we can hit close on that. Now, I'm going to just lock this so this don't move. And you want your video capture under, which is behind here. Now, I'm going to hold down Alt, and I'm going to drag. And then I'm going to do the same on this side. Let's pull that down. And then I'm just going to move it over to this box here. because I don't want it bleeding over to here. So now we have our I can lock that too. Our camera feed here in this box. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a display capture. You can name that whatever you want to. I'll leave that on automatic. I'm going to capture let's capture that screen. Let's hit OK. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this, actually let me shrink it down first, line it up to where I want it to be lined up at, here, about right there, bring that here, and now I can hold down shift and stretch it out if I need to, and then I'm going to move it under media source. So let's bring this in a little bit to where the black line is. And this here. There we go. Now I'm going to lock that. Now we got our display capture over here. So anything I open up on this side here, you'll be able to see it here. So here, if I want to watch a YouTube, I can just click on anything here. Oh, hold on, I forgot to do this. So in OBS, you're going to need to add your microphone. Let's go to audio input, name it whatever you want. Mine is coming in on Focusrite. There we go. Now you can see that it's in mono. Mono signal is coming in. So we need to click here and then go to advanced audio properties and just make it mono. Then we're going to add another source. This going to be output capture. Name that whatever you want. And mine is going to be speakers Focusrite USB audio. Hit OK. And audio output right here. I'm going to go to advanced here. And this time I'm going to make sure so I can hear it in my headphones. I'm going to turn on audio output capture to monitor output. Okay, so when I do play something here, then you start to see the audio level play here. So let's just click on the video.
Pi is a free browser extension that blocks ads on your favorite sites. You install it once and then you can use the internet freely, and you honestly
see my grills.
There we go. So it's just that simple. Well, that's the end of my video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you learn anything. I will be uploading more videos. It'll be different things like, you know, music production, beat making, how to use ChatGPT, how to code, how to make certain applications. So just stay tuned.